I'm here at the Lütze booth for SPS Drives in Nuremberg with Udo Lütze, the owner of the Lütze International Group. Mr. Lütze, you're celebrating 50 years of SuperFlex drag chain cables this year. You can look back on a long tradition.
Absolutely. Flexible cables is a very important part of our DNA here at Lütze. And my father was one of the pioneers during the 60s to develop that kind of technology, and that's something that we're quite proud of.
Why did your father, the company founder Friedrich Lütze, develop drag chain cables at that time?
When he started this business in the early 60s and the late 50s, he was always looking out for his customers and asking the question, what is it that a customer needs? Where are the problems, where are the difficulties, and where are the challenges out there? And he found out that, especially in automation with cable, and in moving applications, there was a big potential for improvement. One example was the construction industry, where they were using rubberized cables for automated equipment, material handling equipment on the construction site. Unfortunately, it didn't last very long. They sometimes had to be replaced more than once a week, which meant shutdown, which meant delays, which meant a lot of costs. So he looked at that situation and asked himself, how can we do this better?
And how did things continue with the flexible cables at Lütze?
Well, we started looking at the applications, not just in the construction industry, but also in the automation industry. And we saw that linear motion was becoming very, very popular. So we asked ourselves, what does it take for a cable to withstand that kind of a motion? What kind of materials do we need to use? What type of construction do we need to use? So we took a very close look at that.
What role did technical progress play in the form of new material and material combinations? Surely more powerful cable constructions are possible over time.
Well, I would say it played a key role because it was very important to use the right materials. These days, when you purchase a cable, you look for certifications from UL, VDE, and so on and so forth, and they all require approved materials. Well, that's one side. The other side is those approved materials, they have to withstand to the flexing motion that comes with the cable. And getting that together is not always very, very easy. You have to make sure that the right stranding is used for the individual wires. If the stranding is too thin, the cable breaks. If it's too thick, it's not flexible enough. Then the entire construction, it's quite demanding.
So everything started on the construction site in the 1960s. Which cables are currently included in your cable portfolio, and which industries do you serve today?
Well, we are primarily focusing on the automation industry, which is a broad, very broad industry. It's a very good market for us, and the spectrum that we have anywhere from static application to highly flexing applications. We have servo cables, we have automation cable, power cable, electronic cable, basically everything that you need in a well-rounded portfolio.
Many thanks for very exciting insights and 50 years of drag chain cables at Lütze.
Thank you.